Are you having trouble with your darkroom? Maybe you just don't have enough room for a darkroom setup? Well, xTool provides a great tool for you. Any one of their lasers can be used to make a stencil for your screen printing needs. All right, let's get started with setting up the screens. The mesh already comes with emulsion on it, which is great. So there's no need to set up your darkroom or do any messy coating. We use the cardboard, we wanna keep this on. We use it to center up our mesh to our frame. Lock the mesh with our locking bars. So we're gonna start at the top and then the bottom. You wanna make sure that your locking bars are centered. There is a divot, or right in the center here, for the locking bar. So if you are too far to the left or the right, you will know, because it won't lock down all the way. We're gonna go ahead and turn our levers, starting with the top levers, and then the sides. They are tight. We can go ahead and remove our cardboard. Now that we have the screen stretched, we need to place it in our laser to create a stencil. Depending on your laser, you may have a bracket that is appropriate for it, and you simply just mount this in your laser, and then your screen will line up to the pins and set in. Just make sure it's nice and taut, and you're ready to go. I am a huge fan of doing test grids. Test grids will allow us to find and determine what settings work best for our final stencil that we need to print shirts. So to do that, I would set up my grid layout, find my parameters, adjust my speed and my powers accordingly in my test grid, and then burn that to a screen. As I'm known for saying in the office here, buy a handful, ruin one. You have a test grid, you know what the settings are, you know for future reference what they'll be. I can find the exact parameters and specifications for my stencils so I know exactly what speed and power to run my design. I'm gonna go ahead and frame this. Depending on the laser, I may need to set my workspace and frame that out. So with like the S1 or P2, we'll need to frame our workspace. After that, I can then frame the design to make sure it's falling right where I want it to be on my workpiece. Once I have that positioned where I like it, I'm gonna go ahead and hit start. This process is gonna take some time. So in the meantime, I'm gonna go ahead and get my inks ready. Wow, this looks great. We can go ahead and get it in press. To adjust our registration, we have our three knobs in the front here. Our left adjustment is gonna control the front end of the screen to get that straight, while our right knob is gonna control the back end of the screen. And then our center knob is going to control the forward and backwards. We're gonna go ahead and click it in. Cinch it down. We have our off contact adjustment here. Make sure our off contact's nice and springy. We can go ahead and use platen tape, or we could use liquid adhesive or mist adhesive. But xTool has these clever little sheets here. There's a light grip and a fabric grip. We're gonna use the light grip sheet here. The pink one's the fabric grip. It's a little stickier. They're sticky on both sides. We're gonna go ahead and just lay this down, lining it up with the grid that is on the platen itself. If they lose their tack or have too much lint on them, you can just wipe them down with water. We're gonna go ahead and load our shirt. Make sure it falls where we want it. I'm actually going to move my shirt over. That's about right. We can go ahead and load some ink. Pop that in here. And using our xTool squeegee. And there we go. Pull this off for you. And we have our print. Wow, color me impressed. This press has definitely shown that it is great for those one color designs. And if you are in a smaller space, a laser does provide a great option for those without a dark room. Or if you do have a dark room or a larger shop, this is definitely a great option for doing those quick one-off color designs. Just setting it up and getting it together was really easy, and I am quite impressed. This is clearly not a tool that's just gonna sit around and gather dust. As we've shown in prior videos, leather patches, ornaments, shadow casters, this is definitely a versatile tool for any shop or DIYer. Another thing I love about this unit is the fact that it's so light and compact that I can just close it up and walk away with it. Hey guys, if you like this video as much as I've enjoyed making it, please be sure to like and subscribe and leave me a comment on where you see the benefits of equipment like this is in your shop. Also, if you know somebody who would enjoy this video, please be sure to share it. All right, this is Daryl from Ryonet. Peace.